How's it going, everyone? I hope you all are having a wonderful day. So for today's video, I wanted to discuss Netflix's Scissor Seven. Scissor Seven is a Chinese anime about a man trying to make a living as a barber while also working a side hustle where he takes on assassination contracts. Again, our main protagonist is a barber who works part-time as an assassin, and also runs a food stand when his other two businesses aren't doing so well. As you can tell, this show is a comedy, but it does also have some nice action scenes. The story is well put together, with the first season acting like the prologue and the second season bringing the full story into view. And with the third season coming out October 3rd, we all have something to look forward to, especially since it seems like the third season may be the last one in the series, which is a real bummer seeing as how entertaining the show has been so far. The story follows our young barber assassin Seven and his chubby chicken friend Daibo. Seven currently has amnesia and is looking for a way to regain his memories. He's also completely broke, so he works as a street vendor to make some money in the meantime. Daibo tells him about this country called Stan and how it's so technologically advanced that they can use their superior intellect and fancy machines to bring back his memory. In the meantime, Daibo wants Seven to work as an assassin in order to make as much money as they can in the least amount of time so they can afford to go to Stan. So, they go around taking random requests from citizens around their island. Seven has the ability to manipulate a pair of scissors with his chi. He can also use an egg created by Daibo to transform into anything he can think of, whether it's an inanimate object or a living person, he can shapeshift into it. Now with these skills, you would think he can easily fulfill his contracts, but Seven is unskilled and uncoordinated. He fails every single hit he takes on. Like the first hit he took on, for example, spoiler warnings by the way, was that this girl wanted him to shave the head of the woman who is currently marrying her ex. She wants him to shave the bride's head during the wedding in order to get the couple to call it off so she can get back together with him. But when Seven was about to go through with it, he got distracted by a slideshow showing the couple's life together. He saw all of the wonderful memories they had and started thinking about what his life was like before he lost his memory. Then the lights came on and everyone saw him shaving the groom's head instead. He doesn't always screw up this bad, but he does screw up every single hit he takes. He usually decides not to kill his target for one reason or another. In this one situation, he even fought the person who hired him. This old lady, Jian Gulian, who's the chairman of the island's purity sect, hired Seven to assassinate this man who goes around wearing women's underwear. Before Seven could complete the hit, Jiang and a couple of her sect members showed up and tried to kill the man themselves. Jiang didn't trust Seven to complete the hit, so she took it upon herself to take him out. It's then revealed that the man doesn't steal women's underwear, he buys clean underwear to wear. When Seven heard this, he couldn't accept this man dying just because he's a little different, so he fought off the three purity sect members, saving the man's life. Now, the fights themselves were entertaining and well put together, it's just the animation style is not my favorite. Don't get me wrong, it's not horrible, the show is actually pretty good, but I feel this animation style works really well for the comedic scenes, but not for the action scenes. Again, they are not bad, it's just a matter of personal taste. Let's take a look at the previous fight, for example, to show you what I mean. As you can see, the animation doesn't look choppy or half-heartedly put together, it's smooth and natural. It's just a style that I'm not a fan of. I don't hate it per se, and it's definitely not a turnoff. Also, the way this fight ends is completely hilarious. Also, for those of you wondering why the voices don't match the subtitle, it's because the subtitles are translating what they are saying in Mandarin, not what the English voice actors are saying. Anyways, the animation is well put together, but not high quality. Personally, I think it works. It could have been better, but clearly the animation is not the show's selling point. It's the characters themselves and how they handle the situations they are in. Seven is honestly one of the better written protagonists. He's not skilled or strong in the normal sense of the word. However, he is incredibly talented and experienced, but due to his amnesia, he's unable to fight to his fullest potential. His ki cannot manipulate anything bigger than his scissors, so he can't manipulate a sword or anything like that, but he doesn't need to, because at the end of the first season, we learn he can manipulate a tremendous amount of tiny shards to get past any defense. In his current state, he can't use that ability to its fullest potential. However, when he has a small glimpse of his previous life, he will gain the knowledge of his old fighting style, which made him one of the most feared assassins in the world. He also has a magic sword that has compromised the broken shards that he can wield using that technique. So we see that when he temporarily awakens to his previous self and has that sword, no one can compete with him. But when he's in his current state, he can't use it. His talent lies in his experience with wielding the magic sword. He's not your typical overpowered protagonist. He does have natural talent, but his skills come from his experience, and when he lost that experience, he became a normal fighter. So his strength does come at a cost. His current self is a kind and caring goofball, while his past self was a cold-blooded, heartless killer, who sought strength at any cost. There is more to his backstory, but as of the second season, we haven't seen all of it yet, so we don't know how he became an assassin and why he defected. We do see how he lost his memory, but not the events that led up to it. So we still have some character development to look forward to. He does make a lot of friends who are just as goofy as him, and all of their interactions with one another is just off the charts in terms of how hilarious it actually is. And that's pretty much this show's selling point. Like this scene with He Da-chun, who went up against Seven, but then befriended him when he learned that he was actually a good person despite being an assassin. This scene is what made me want to watch Scissor Seven in the first place, so it's only natural that I make you guys watch it as well.
Didn't put you on the assassination list with everyone else, huh?
What are you doing out here?
Oh, we're just out on a date.
There are killers on the island. It's not safe at night. I can guard you both.
Wow, that's really kind of you to offer. Would you mind giving us a little room for privacy?
Is this enough space for you?
Do only weirdos live here? Wait. Is that the Da-chun? He has a reward. Why don't you come closer, handsome? Come on. Handsome. 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 Why are you ignoring me?
You were calling to me? I'm not handsome. What are you talking about?
I guess I just have a thing for tough guys with buzz cuts. Pentagonal heads.
Don't say that. Your boyfriend's right there. The indestructible virgin!
What a waste, a virgin with a body like that.
Huh? What gives, lady? Are you a killer?
Took you a while.
As you can see, this show is absolutely hilarious, and it's also deep at the same time with the character's internal dilemma. Should he obtain the strength to protect the island in exchange for his humanity? Or should he steal his resolve and remain the weak yet lovable doofus whom the island dwellers tolerate and rely on? They do seem to care for him, but it doesn't seem like they love or cherish him. Except maybe a few characters here and there. All in all, I do recommend watching the show. It was a really good time, and most likely the final season is about to start airing, if it hasn't already started by the time this video is uploaded. This show brings an excellent combination of action and comedy, as well as some pretty nice character development with the whole, the protagonist is super overpowered, but he can't fight using his full strength because he can't remember how to due to his amnesia situation. It's a simple premise, but the fact that Seven's strength lies in the hardship he's faced while growing up ended up causing him to seek out power, and now that those hardships are no longer a part of his character, he no longer has the ability to protect those he cares for. So he's stuck in this loop, where he's trying to enjoy his time on the island with all of the inhabitants, but he can't because they are in constant danger, and he doesn't have the strength to protect them. So he has to make a choice, to either give himself over to his dark past, or continue to remain in the light where he's weak but surrounded by all of his friends. Either way, he's going to have to fight. It's just a matter of who he's going to fight as. The island's strongest hairstylist, or the world's strongest assassin. And that's going to be it for this one, folks. Shorter video this time around, but I wanted to talk about the show without getting too into it. It's an awesome series that I highly recommend watching, so I'd like to thank you all so much for watching. I truly appreciate it. I look forward to seeing you in the next one, and remember to keep having fun. See ya!